how to fix Wi-Fi on all Macs. In this video, we'll learn how to determine if this is a software or hardware Wi-Fi issue, how Wi-Fi works internally, and how to replace all Wi-Fi cards. Essentially, this video will help you fix any Wi-Fi issue on any OS X operating system. On any Mac running the most current operating system, click the Apple logo and go to About This Mac. Click System Report on the window that pops up. Scroll down, find the Networking tab, and click Wi-Fi. Once you click Wi-Fi, if you see data loaded in this window, this means that the operating system actually loaded the KEX and recognized the network card when it was booting up. At this point, it is quite possible that you're experiencing a software issue. There's one way to deal with this. Go ahead and go to the Apple logo and go to System Preferences. Select Network. Highlight Wi-Fi. Scroll down and press the minus sign. Hit Apply. This will delete the Wi-Fi network profile. Now go ahead and click the plus sign. On the drop-down window, select Wi-Fi and click Create. This will recreate the Wi-Fi network profile. Click to turn it on and press Apply. Once turned on, click on the top right corner Wi-Fi logo and attempt to connect to your network. If you've connected successfully, then you have solved your problem. This software remedy quite commonly fixes Wi-Fi issues. This procedure is quite similar in older operating systems. Click the Apple logo and go to About This Mac. Press More Info. On the next window, click System Report. Scroll down, select Wi-Fi under the Networking tab. If you see data here, that means the KEX was loaded in your operating system when the computer was started, so the operating system can actually see the Wi-Fi card. Click the Apple logo again and go to System Preferences. Select the network icon. Here we'll have to unlock the access to change these settings. Go ahead and scroll down to the lock on the bottom left corner and unlock it. Go ahead and select Wi-Fi and press minus. Now press plus, create the Wi-Fi profile again, and hit apply. Attempt to connect to your network now. If you've successfully connected to your network by using this remedy, then you have fixed your problem. If your Wi-Fi issue is still not resolved, or you didn't see any data underneath the Networking Wi-Fi tab, then there's a hardware issue. Let's talk about hardware issues now. Every Wi-Fi system made by Apple or any other company has these following three choke points. The Wi-Fi card itself can break, the Wi-Fi cable connection can be severed, and the Wi-Fi antenna connection can be severed. All three of these can cause Wi-Fi to stop functioning. Let's familiarize ourselves with some of the Apple laptops to get a good idea of how a Wi-Fi system is hooked up. For this instance, we're using a 2008 MacBook Pro. We're going to take off the bag and show you exactly how things are hooked up. The antenna is located right here, and it runs all the way down and plugs into the logic board. So the antenna and the Wi-Fi card are actually inside of the LCD screen in this model. This connection can come apart and cause the Wi-Fi to stop working. From 2008 to 2010, the Wi-Fi cards were located inside of the LCD screen. Let's have a look inside and see exactly how it's structured. After removing this bezel, we can go ahead and have a peek in and see that the Wi-Fi card is being hooked up through this cable. And the Wi-Fi card itself is located right here. Then there's the two antenna cables that hook into the Wi-Fi card, and the antenna is right next to the Wi-Fi card. If you've taken this unit apart and noticed that all the connections are fine, it is most likely the card that needs replacing. Here's an example of a different Wi-Fi system that Apple used from 2010 to 2012. There's a Wi-Fi card that becomes disconnected quite a lot right here. The Wi-Fi card itself is no longer inside the LCD. You must disconnect this cable and verify that it is not broken on either side. You can also remove and inspect the Wi-Fi card itself. Also inspect the antenna connections, because the antenna is still stored inside of the LCD on these models. When you're observing this, make sure that everything is clicked in properly. 2010 to current MacBook Airs and all MacBooks after 2012 have the following Wi-Fi technology. The antenna is still inside the LCD, but there is a small little card that you can remove by detaching a T5 screw and pulling out the card. Now that we have a solid foundation of how Wi-Fi works, let's go ahead and determine how to replace your specific Wi-Fi card. We first need to identify your MacBook. Click on the Apple logo and go to About This Mac. Here you'll find your MacBook size and year. Now on any other computer or a smartphone, open up a browser and navigate to AppleDollars.com. Once at AppleDollars.com, scroll down and select your Mac type. For this example, we'll use MacBooks, a 15-inch MacBook that's from the 2010 era. Here you'll find an interactive video map. Locate the network card and watch the replacement video on how to replace the network card for your specific Mac. AppleDollars.com has network card replacement videos for every type of Mac. This concludes this tutorial. Thank you for watching.